everyone. Today we are going to paint a beautiful poppy field on a stretch canvas, and I'll be providing all the tips that you need to know if you are using the stretch canvas for the first time. I'm using a wooden palette in this video, and I haven't removed the cover of this wooden palette so that it will be easier for me to clean the palette after you. There goes my regular set of brushes, some tissues, and my favorite Fevicryl acrylic colors. Separating the sky and the poppy field. First tip from me: if you are new to stretch canvas is costlier than canvas boards, and so it is better to start painting on smaller size canvas, and gradually as you improve you can go for larger canvas. Second tip is that never leave the sides as such. You should always paint the sides of the canvas just the same way as you are painting the front side. First, you may apply the colors roughly, and then for bringing a perfect gradient to the sky, you should clean the brush, wipe off the excess water, and then do some blending like this. You can leave the sky like this. Adding the clouds is totally optional. Properly to the background, and for that I am using a dry flat brush. This process is not that tough as it seems to be. If you follow the steps properly, you can easily paint the clouds. Thank you. is something that you really need if you are very much serious about painting. Here I am using it for adding the highlights to the clouds. Here I'm trying to add some more brightness to the sky with lime yellow. I'll be showing you two different techniques for painting the poppy flowers at a distance. One is with the help of earbuds and the other is with the help of a round brush. Some contrast here by adding a bit of green. as red spread because it's all red here. And if you love watching the video, please do hit the like button and please do subscribe to my channel for more videos. Thank you so much for watching and stay happy.